Are you sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin. Once upon a time, there were a little girl and a little boy. They were born the same day. You see, their parents were neighbors and friends and helped each other out quite a bit. They lived in a faraway village somewhere in Russia. There wasn't much going on in the village, so the two friendly families spent lots of wonderful times together, especially on holidays. The evening like this, by the fire. Everything seemed fantastical to children. The ice drawings on a frosted window sparkled in a cool winter sun. Children spent all their time playing together. Here they're riding toy horses. And here a little boy plays with an army of toy soldiers that his father carved for him from the branch of an old tree that grows in the yard. And Nanny told them fairy tales of evil witch from the woods. and little girl loved twirling to the sounds of the waltz her mother played on the piano. One day the village burst to life when the carnival came. Children begged their parents to take them out to see the carnival. It was the first time they ventured out of the safe harbor of their homes. The first thing they saw was a man playing a very strange instrument, accordion. It seems to grow and shrink in his hands, making unusual sounds. Then they saw a group of dancers doing unthinkable things with their bodies, jumping and turning midair. Carnival changed their lives forever. Now, children wanted to see the rest of the world and all the wonders in it. When they became teenagers, they asked that their parents take them. First stop, Poland. Children found Poland too formal, so they quickly found local kids to play with. But it was when they got to Italy that their heart sang along with infectious tunes of Italian songs. Next came Germany. Napoli in early spring is magic. They sat in the parks for hours and hours and hours, listening to the bird song all around them. Thank you. And so years went by. Children were no longer children. Their parents stayed behind while they continued their travels and found a new home in Europe. Many springs later, one March, they heard a lark that brought such memories and such longing. They didn't even notice how they fell in love. Having spent their entire lives together, they found themselves one night stargazing at a deserted beach. And a new love story was born.
Thank you.
It seemed so natural. Life got faster. They became parents themselves. Many years later, one autumn day, they sat by the fire and reminisced about their parents, who are now gone, and their childhood in a remote Russian countryside.
Thank you.
when their children grew up, they too wanted to go travel. And they went even farther than their parents. They wanted to see the new world. So our couple led them and wondered, though, have they taught them enough about a life of a traveler? They kept in touch all the time. The summers, the winters, and summers again. And this one particularly rainy summer day, they were again on the phone together. But as they learned that their children haven't really learned much from their teachings and were discovering the world empirically, making the same mistakes they have made themselves and their parents warned them about. Thank you. But they were content, for their children were happy. They were making their own way in the world, just as they have themselves. They loved each other and lived a beautiful life and died on the same day, just like the day they were born. For an encore, I would like to play for you my transcription of Korngold's Das Wunder der Helena. It's a very rare opera in which the storyline is epic. It is love that conquers death, literally. It's very much like a Greek tragedy where star-crossed lovers are united no matter what the obstacles are.
Thank you. Thank you.